Hello, and thank you very much for attending this presentation. My name is Paraskevi Sarri, and I'm a PhD candidate at the University of Southampton. The title of today's presentation is Identifying the Land Use Effects of New Transport Technologies. More specifically, we're going to talk about the case of West Midlands. The outline of today's presentation includes background knowledge from the literature, as well as information for the case study, analysis of the methodology that was followed, and then discussion on the results and the final conclusion. The field of transportation is currently experiencing radical changes with the introduction of new disruptive technologies, such as automated vehicles and electric vehicles. Such innovations are expected to change everyday travel, impact people's lives, and create financial opportunities. Transport is highly interrelated with land use, as we can see in the diagram on the slide, which is the famous land use and transport feedback circle. To express this interrelation, land use and transport interaction (LUTI) models have been developed, and the aim of this research is to identify the impact that the aforementioned disruptive technologies will have on land use. There is a variety of methodology of LUTI models, but only one was needed to be chosen to complete the simulation scenario, and it was chosen based on its methodological characteristics. The chosen LUTI model is Delta. As it is accessibility-based, it has an analytic land use component, it is dynamic, and it also gives the ability to model in multi-level scales of analysis. Because Delta works on multi-level zones, it is feasible to analyze scenarios at both regional and urban level. However, before explaining the methodology, it is important to demonstrate why this specific case study was chosen. At the regional level of analysis, the whole region of West Midlands has been chosen, and at the urban level of analysis, the city of Coventry has also been chosen. The region is one of the most growing areas in England, excluding London, and has historic links with the automotive industry and investments in the sector. Finally, it's one of the most accessible regions in the UK by road and rail. Moving now to the methodology, the variable that affects the accessibility measures in Delta and as a result the distribution of activities is generalized cost, and thus this methodology was focused on estimating this variable. Estimations of the proportions of travel of new technologies in the fleet and changes in generalized costs were combined from various sources to find the change in generalized costs for each purpose and for each simulation year. In total, we have seven scenarios. First, we have the business as usual scenario. Then, the following three scenarios are relevant to the existence of new transport technologies in the city of Coventry, urban scenarios U1, U2, and U3, as you can see on the slide. And then the final three, to the existence of the same technologies on the region of West Midlands, regional scenarios R1, R2, and R3, as you can see again on the slide. More specifically, U1 and R1 are scenarios where we only have electric vehicles. In U2 and R2, we have a combination of electric and level 2 autonomous vehicles. And in U3 and R3, we have electric, level 2, and level 3 autonomous vehicles that happen to occur in different points in time. Moving now to the results section, the two variables presented chronologically are the impact of the urban scenarios on the business as usual scenario, on population in the first graph and employment in the second. For the U1 scenario presented in blue, with the incorporation of electric vehicles, both variables seem to have a very low change and that does not even surpass 0.5%. It is interesting that the population and employment have opposite trends, even though it is expected that they should alter with similar trends and simultaneously. For the U2 scenario presented in orange, after the incorporation of electric vehicles and level 2 autonomous vehicles, both population and employment increase, meaning that unlike U1, the two variables now have the same trends. However, it is essential to mention that percentages range from -0.5% to 0.5%. The most interesting element is that in the 2022-2032 period, there are positive variables on both employment and population change, but that's not the case in the following period. For the U3 scenario, presented in grey, with the existence of all three technologies, both employment and population increase gradually and with higher percentages from the two previous scenarios. In order to understand the results even further, cartographical representations were also created in order to evaluate the spatial distribution of activities. Starting with the U1 scenario on the left, to understand why employment and population follow opposite trends, in the cartographical representation, the population is separated between working adults and retired. In the long run, there are more zones where the number of working adults decreases, hence the distribution of working adults follows now the pattern of employment. Regarding the spatial distribution of activities, the urban center seems to lose its financial power gradually and at a very slow rate. Following with the U2 scenario on the right, to understand why after the 2032 we have a downward trend in the graph, the maps also included housing rent. Initially, the existence of lower cost private mobility increased accessibility and both variables increased. As a result, the housing rent also increased, which later in the simulation period resulted into a decrease in population of working adults, especially in the urban core. As a result, since the population was distributed in other zones, new job opportunities arose there. Finally, for the U3 scenario, because it is evident that we have urban sprawl in the maps, it was expected that the existence of even more innovative technologies, smaller urban cores, can be formed in the peripheral area of the city. As a result, the current Burgess monocentric model that the city follows will be transformed into a polycentric model. Moving now to the results of the regional scenarios, it was concluded that for the R1 scenario presented in blue, population and employment face a decrease. But as also concluded in the U1 scenario, the change does not even surpass 0.5% in absolute terms. For the R2 scenario presented in orange, the scenario follows the same trend as in R1 and the percentages indicate higher reduction in comparison with R1. For the R3 scenario presented in gray, overall the results are higher in absolute terms, which is expected as in this scenario bigger cost changes were modeled. It is evident from the cartographical representation of the regional scenarios that for the R1 scenario on the left, working adults and retired population follow now the same similar spatial trends. And in conclusion, it is clear from the results of the electric vehicles that the spatial distribution of activities does not change in high percentages. For the R2 scenario on the right, working adult and employment in the region are now attracted to the periphery and Birmingham, forming essentially three concentric circular zones. The first being Birmingham, where we have the two variables that increase. The second is a group of zones around Birmingham, where especially working population is decreasing. And the final is a ring around the zones of the peripheral area of the region, where working adults increased in comparison with the business as usual scenario. And finally, for the R3 scenario, both employment and population are decreased, and regionally it is evident that financial cores as well as peripheral areas attract the two variables. Thus, it is expected that if other cities in adjacent regions adopt these technologies, their financial cores will gain power and new, smaller financial centers will be formed in the borders of this region. The periphery of the region appears to attract population and employment, especially in the R3 scenario. This means that it was essential to examine the effects at a set of buffer zones around the region. It is clear that both working adults and employment are increased, even in zones outside the boundaries of the study area after 20 years. The coexistence of new technologies provides higher freedom in mobility and acceptance in longer distance trips. Hence, the phenomenon led to spatial redistribution of activities, which did not only affect the region, but the adjoint regions and their financial opportunities as well. In conclusion, some important elements should be noted. Modeling new transportation technologies can provide valuable spatial results in order to plan towards sustainability. Results of the urban scenarios could not be generalized to the regional level of analysis and vice versa. And finally, different technologies will have different land use effects. Thank you very much.